Okay, RVR and JC 1353.
Sir, if I prepare a learning resource and I want to put it in my WordPress, I know that I have to make sure that it is under Creative Commons.
Okay.
Could you please enlighten us as to how I can get the Creative Commons for the learning resource which I have prepared?
So basically the website where you get more information about Creative Commons is the site creativecommons.org. There are different types of licenses available. Each one has its own images or icons, and the way in which it has to be written. The guidelines are available. So if you actually select creativecommons.org/choose, you can actually select the type of Creative Commons license that you want, and you will get a web. So suppose you want to do it in a web, or if you want to do it as an icon, you will get the necessary Creative Commons statement. So the site to check is creativecommons.org.
Sir, this is a general question. In the yesterday's session in the morning, Professor Bhatak was saying that to change the mindsets of the students, local language is very essential. Are there any softwares? Because as you know, since yesterday we are watching faculty from different parts of the country, like from Tamil Nadu and also from other parts of the country, they are participating in this session. So is there any software where we can interact with the students in the discussion forums in our local language so that we can change the mindsets of the students? Like Moodle and MOOCs mainly focus on the English language. Most of the students try to prefer to interact with the local language. Are there any softwares which is coming up so that we can change the mindsets, which is an important issue?
There are two parts of it. One is, are there local language softwares? The second is about changing mindsets. Changing mindsets, yes, you need to work at your end to provide effective teaching learning experience for the students. And regarding local language software, so Moodle is available in Spanish. So that is one beauty of free and open source softwares. Anybody can contribute to free and open source softwares based on their skill sets. So for example, Wikipedia, which is a largest repository of resources, offer the wikis in multiple languages like Russian, Indian local language like Hindi, I think even Tamil is available in Wikipedia. Now there are several special interest groups that are working on local language related softwares. As of now, as and when we come across these softwares, we'll be definitely letting you know. This is RC Sri Ishwar College of Engineering.
I have one question. How will you evaluate a resource creation assessment?
Okay, so typically resource creation assignments have not yet been published. Currently, we are giving very open-ended rubrics where you learn the peer review process. There is a video which talks about the peer review process. So how you will evaluate is basically through peer review and then answering some questions regarding the peer review. So the resource creation assignments for FDP 101X will come in week 4 and week 5.
Sir, related to resource creation, okay. When do you add both the resource creation in week 1 and week 2? When can we expect that?
So week 1 and week 2 had practice activities there. So though the title said resource creation, it is not a graded activity as of now. So you are creating a resource of course journal. You already have created a practice website. You are actually practicing learning management systems through the demo Moodle course and various other mechanisms across this FDP. The exact resource creation assignments for this FDP will come in week 4 and week 5.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. RC 1331.
This is Dr. KK Pradhan from BIT Mesra.
Yeah, tell me.
So,
sir,
there is a question for preparation of week 2 course journal, whether you prepare a new one or will update the course journal of the week 1.
You will update the week one of course journal. So course journal is a continuous process. If you hear the video regarding course journal clearly, so across the same course you will have only one one document. So consider this as a notebook for a course. So until and unless the notebook gets over, you won't be able to using a new notebook, right?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so
we have to upload it after preparation. We have to upload it, na?
So the instructions regarding upload of course journal will come in week 5. Essentially, you will have to upload it in course journal. So the specific user story for course journal will be informed in week 5.
Namaste, sir. It is a request from our side to extend the grace period for this week 2 submissions.
Okay,
of the assignments.
In case people have not heard it, I said the exact words at 3:30. We are extending the deadlines to tomorrow evening. Okay. The lab 2 assignment also will be uploaded by tomorrow morning. So please do not worry about due dates of graded activities today. We are hopeful of IIT Bombay X stabilizing by tomorrow. In any case, there will be due date extension as it is a technology glitch from our end.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
So let me just reiterate what I have been saying. Currently, there won't be any lab assignment in this on lab assignment 2, which is being uploaded now, because IIT Bombay X system is having some trouble. We'll upload the lab assignment 2 by tomorrow, and we are going to extend the due dates for all the graded activities to appropriate time as and when IIT Bombay X is stable. Yeah, RC1100, I'm able to hear you, sir.
Hello, good afternoon, JK sir.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Hats off to you for your patience hearing of all the questions. We are having a couple of questions. I am handing over the mic to one of our participants.
Yeah, please.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
So maybe simple question. What are the list of softwares and hardwares and the minimum budget required to record our own lectures, maybe in our cabin or maybe in the classroom?
Okay. So are there any other questions? I'll come take each questions together and I'll tell about answer. I'll tell the answer together.
Sir, as knowing that today is the last date for week 2 graded activities.
Yes.
We have already submitted, those who have already submitted, knowing that today is the last date, without spending much time on that activity. So we don't have now option further, because we thought today is the last date, and as we are attending this AVU sessions, we submitted already without giving much enough time on those activities, spending time on those activities. So we don't have options anymore now. What shall we do? What shall such participants do?
Okay, so the quick answer is, the if you submit well before due date, then it is always a good practice. However, we'll try to ensure that there is some common grading allowance. Like we'll take the best 3 out of 5 or best 4 out of 5, etc. When we actually do the grading, so that in case you do miss out on one activity, you will not be penalized for it. So the same holds good for people who have not done week 1 activities as well. We'll ensure that there is a common grading policy wherein we'll allow we'll select the best course. We'll make sure that one quiz is droppable in each of them, so that you will have better results. Regarding your question on video creation, week 4 specifically deals with video creation software. There are a list of software that we'll be providing you in week 4, and one activity is actually creation of a video from at your own place. So please do not worry about the list of softwares. It is going to come in week 4. Center 1143, Indore Institute of Engineering Technology. Yeah,
sir, you given a number of mentor list. So how can choose who is the best mentor for me, and how can connect to mentor?
So the question is regarding, is there a provision of selecting the best mentor? Kindly note that currently we don't have a provision as to identifying the best mentor or things like that. As Professor Fatak said, this is actually an innovative experiment that we are carrying out from our end. We believe that all the 184 top performers from previous FDP are very well capable of handling your queries, and they are excellent mentors. If you actually look at discussion forum, the way they are interacting with you, you will understand that they are answering most of your queries. Maybe in the future versions of the FTP, we will look at providing you an option of mentor, but see, currently the system is being tested out even from our end itself. How effective are the mentor-mentee interactions and things like that. You will be providing us the first input about who is a good mentor and things like that. Let me now go to 1128, Visheshwaraya National Institute of Technology in Nagpur.
We have two questions, sir.
So my first question is regarding, we get images in Google and we can have a filter over it.
Yes.
But same thing, can it be done for videos which are available in TED Talk or YouTube? And as well as, what are the process to overcome for the contents which we are going to publish for a particular thing?
Can you repeat the final question? It's not clear, as in...
contents, course content. Suppose we have prepared our course material and we are publishing it. Definitely it will be from some research book or from authorized person. So whether it will cause a plagiarism if we publish it in our website, personal website.
Okay, so the first is regarding filtering in YouTube and other video sharing sites. Yes, it is available. If you actually go to YouTube, you can see options over there, filter by Creative Commons. You can select duration of the video, let's say 4 minutes, 4 minute to 7 minute long videos, Creative Commons itself, label for reuse, label for commercial reuse, label for non-commercial reuse, etc. It's available in YouTube itself. You will have to go to the filters in YouTube to better understand this. Regarding guidelines for publishing your own online content, just ensure that you get sufficient permission from the authors or the source from where you are taking those resources. And if it is available in Creative Commons, you provide sufficient attribution to it. If there are research papers, you properly cite it. All these things are the important thing, important guidelines that you have to remember while creating your own online course.
Hello.
Yeah.
Our second question. Sir, in our FTP, there is a structure that you share a video and later on immediately you ask the knowledge quiz, means arrange knowledge quiz, reflections quiz and assimilation quiz.
Yes.
Now using the same module, if we want to develop a similar module for our students, for our own course, using some online platform, is there any facility available so that our university syllabus and our university results should not be compromised? And also we will be interested if we, because this FDP has been conducted last year also, so is there any success story or case study which you can share on the similar way which has been implemented for the student, not for the teachers?
The question number one, so let me answer the second question first. All the associate faculty who are part of this FDP, they are by themselves the success stories of the previous FDP. If you actually go and look their WordPress sites, you will see how different they have used various resources and are also trying to integrate ICT in their own classroom. Regarding your first question, can you repeat the first question regarding, okay, your first question is regarding reflection quiz and other things. See, please note that all these terminologies, they are defined by us because the model of learner-centered MOOC is developed at IIT Bombay, wherein we say that any online course or even regular teaching learning has to be learner-centered. So if you actually look at reflection spots, they are equivalent to the questions that you pose to the students during regular teaching learning within their classroom. We have just modified that in an online format by making use of let's say the facilities provided by the technology, let's say video. We have editors, video editors, which we can actually use for doing a lot of stuff. And the other questions like knowledge quiz, reflection quiz, they are simply multiple choice questions. If you carefully see, each of them is a multiple choice question, and any online learning management system will support it. Only thing is that we are calling it by a name called reflection quiz or assimilation quiz or things like that. What we want you to take away from this course is that even your regular face-to-face teaching can be improved by small pedagogic adaptations like reflection spots, or wherein you pause for some time, make sure that the students get engaged. By doing these kind of activities, you will have a better teaching learning in your own classroom. Regarding compromising your syllabus, it is up to individual faculty to see how much the syllabus gets modified. Or so if you actually look at the curriculum for the current FDP, we have lot of things in module 1, module 2, etc. But the way we have delivered the content, it is completely different, and we have tried to align it to the learning objectives that is expected from the students. So basically, what we want you to take away from this FDP is like how the different pedagogic practices within this FDP can be easily implemented even in your regular face-to-face teaching learning process.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, let me now move to Mukesh Patel, School of Technology and Management.
First of all, hats off to you for patiently and passionately fielding so many questions for the previous 2 hours.
Yeah.
We have a certain problem here that Dr. Samir Shastrabuddhe's session, the first session, we could not view the document, any of the slides. And the second session, we missed due to a server issue at our remote center. So first of all, can we get his sessions, video sessions, on the YouTube link which you are going to be providing? And can we get his presentations on the graphics and visual, on graphics and visual presentation, his PPT? Because I am thinking that you will have some questions in your lab activity on Dr. Sahasrabuddhe's session.
Okay, so my studio team is telling me that Dr. Sahasrabuddhe's session has not been put in YouTube. However, what we can ensure is that you get all the slides that were associated with the session. We'll be uploading it in IIT Bombay X itself in the course handouts. Please wait a day. The video also will be, we are trying to upload the video from our end.
One more doubt, can you please clarify?
Yeah.
That the lab activity will be available for the participants, and when we can do it from our individual desktops?
So, we are hoping that we can have the lab assignment 2 up by tomorrow afternoon, 12 o'clock. And we'll give 1 day's time for doing the lab activity.
We don't have to come to the remote center.
No. So, that will be available in IIT Bombay X, and you can access it from your own place.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. Let me just go to the next RC, 1069. Aluri Institute of Management Sciences, Warangal.
Yes, sir. There is a one small observation what we made. We want to share it with you, sir.
Sure.
So, the one thing is that when we are going through the week 2, huh. LEDs.
Okay.
So, there in that web presence when creating a hall and when we had done it, huh. And finally went through, we are seeing through WordPress, huh. User website, there WP admin is not visible. In the latest version of WordPress.
Okay, so it is a...
So what we have identified is that, when we type in that user ID dot W, suppose in my case, drpschendra.wordpress.com
okay.
/ WP hyphen admin.
Yes.
If we type it, then we are able to go to the control panel.
Yes.
This is the observation actually made.
Yes.
I just want to share this across to the all the people.
Yeah.
Because they will be able to know that.
Yeah.
Because in the LEDs, the older version was available.
Yes.
So there in that My View site, the WP admin was straight away was showing.
Yes.
So user can be able to directly click and open that control panel, adding menus, post everything, they can able to configure it.
Yes.
But whereas in this latest version, what we have been doing, it is not visible.
Yes.
So there what we need to type is that. So through this, I want to convey to all the participants, to our peer, that your user ID. Like example, in my case, drpschendra.wordpress.com. After that, put a slash, type wp-admin. And if you press enter, then automatically it will go to the one new page will be open. There your WP admin enter will be, dashboard will be visible.
Okay.
Where you can configure all your this thing. Okay. So this is the request I want to make to you. You also please make note that and please inform to everybody. Because I think it as an interactive, it is already able to know. So please post through the TA.
Okay.
Post.
So thank you, Professor. Thank you, Professor, for this information. Yes, there is a version difference in WordPress. And I believe many of the community TAs have also pointed this out in in the discussion forum. But I will definitely tell all the participants to check the version changes. Please note that as Professor Shendra said, you will have to type WP admin manually. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah. drpschendra.wordpress.com/wp-admin.
Yes.
So I hope everybody will be able to note that. That is the reason I was repeating it. So there is one more query, sir.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, we have been following the week one classes without fail and we've really been benefited out of it. But not being aware of the assimilative and reflective exercises, we thought that before every lecture, whatever questions are there at the end, we were sincerely answering those questions, but we failed to answer the assimilative, reflective and knowledge test, which is on the other one. And in the week two, we have realized we have done, but now I don't think so. It is accepting anymore. So is there any remedy for this?
Okay, this is regarding week one activity. Unfortunately, for week one, we won't be able to extend the deadline anymore. However, as a global policy, we are going to extend the due dates for all the week two activities by another day or so, so that you can access the stable IIT Bombay X and answer the queries. It's only one day because you are still not, many of the users are still not able to access it. However, as a general policy, what we'll also try to do is we'll look at the top, let's say we'll ensure that you have some relaxation regarding graded activities, wherein we'll select only the top few graded activities out of the total number of graded activities. However, this requires a careful discussion by the course instructors. And new policy will be announced on this Thursday. Okay, let me now go to Amrita School of Engineering, Kollam, Kerala.
Good evening, sir. It's long day for you.
Yeah,
it Hats is. Off to you.
Yeah, thank you.
I just want to, I just want to congratulate you. And my question is, I deal with soft skills.
Okay.
So it's not the hard skills part. So wherein I want to initiate this discussion mode amongst the students, which number to more than 500. So, is it possible to replicate what you are doing right now?
Yes, it is. It is possible.
I mean, monitoring so many. Okay, monitoring so many students. Can we do it?
So, you need a set of TAs or like what we have in faculty associates. You should have sufficient number of people who are monitoring it. Individually, managing 500 people will not be an easy task.
Mammoth task.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and is there any particular forum that I need to register or something? I mean, I'm not a techie person, so I'm not very sure about that.
So basically,
WordPress, I do go there to blog.
So any of the ICT tools that we are discussing in this particular FDP, all of them provide support for discussions. So be it the learning management system or be it the content management systems. It really depends on what your objectives are and what all features you want to use. Based on that, you can select the appropriate technology.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, one more. There's one more question.
Yeah.
Good evening, Jayakrishnan, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
The question is that about discussion forum. In the week one course, I had uploaded my journal. And I saw that one person had peer-reviewed my journal. And he had commented on the journal.
Okay.
And when I posted, I actually didn't understand what he had commented.
Okay.
He had commented like in the first page, second and third line, he had commented something.
Okay.
So it's about the genuinity of the comment as well as when I replied with a question about what the comment is. Can you explain it more clearly? After that, I didn't hear anything from him. So I think there should be a notice like when someone comments and a reply is posted, I should be able to know what is happening next.
Okay.
And similarly, I also posted like 3 or 2 comments. So on top of my comment, if someone comments, they should also be, I should also be noticed, even if I am not following that particular comment.
Okay. So the query is regarding discussion forum, how it could be. Okay. So let me answer regarding individual participants. Practice in the discussion forum, it really boils down to the individual on how he or she actually participates in the discussion forum. Now, what we can do is we can encourage more participation, send out weekly emails. Currently, we don't have a forum alert in the current version of the OpenEDX software that is being used for IIT Bombay X. However, in the next version of OpenEDX, we will have mail notifications about discussion forum activity, which will ensure that you will be intimated about responses and replies on your own comment.
Oh, that is wonderful. I was expecting that.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Please note that it's almost 4:40 at our end. I understand that all of you have queries. I'll be able to take another 5 queries from the remote centers. You can post your queries in the question section, wherein I'll answer each of them individually across the coming week, and I'll be able to better tell you answers and clarifications for your queries. So please post in chat as well as post it in the questions. Now I'm moving to RC1008, DKTE Society's Textile and Engineering Technology Institute.
Will you please guide us about how peer assessment can be performed more effectively?
Okay.
Peer assessment.
Okay. Peer assessment can be made. So the question is how to make peer assessment more effective. One is by use of a very detailed rubric. And second is make sure that the participant gets sufficient training in peer review. These are the two mechanisms through which peer assessments can be made more effective.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello. Sir, can we integrate AV with WordPress?
At this moment, I'm not sure. I think the answer is no. However, what you can do is check the source code of WordPress and see whether some integration features can be made possible. So currently, AV is only for virtual classrooms.
Sir, I'm having one idea about use of AV.
Okay.
Okay. AV can be utilized for having paper presentation competitions.
Yes.
For students.
Yes. So many colleges have been utilizing AVU for these kind of competitions. Across the past few years, since this is a Government of India project, it has been used in various ways. Let's say paper presentation, project presentations, etc. Even for hackathons, the AVU interactions were utilized for ensuring there is a synchronous interaction. I'll now move to the next RC1113, SB Patil College of Engineering, Indapur, Pune.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, my first question is generic. We have 2 questions. One is myself, Yogesh Bhandwar, workshop coordinator. Why we are not allowed to be a participant of such a wonderful workshop? Being a coordinator of this workshop, I am losing my chance actually.
Okay, so the quick answer to it is that you haven't applied to the same workshop when the notification was released. So the notification was released almost a month back, and we had sent out emails to all remote centers telling them about this information, that this FDP is going to come in 2 modes and you can register. So,
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. After registering as a workshop coordinator, I tried for registering myself as a participant.
Okay.
But the message was like, you are not authorized to be a participant of this workshop.
Quick question. Did you actually attend the 4-week FDP last year, which was done by us last year?
No, actually. But I was interested at all in for this particular workshop. As a coordinator also and as a participant also.
Okay, so the quick question, I'll check with the workshop team, plus do not get disheartened, because this FDP is going to be offered again in January, where we'll have more mentors, more number of people assisting us, and we are planning to have perpetual FDPs like these run through IIT Bombay. So please do not get disheartened. I'll definitely check why, what exactly was the technical reason due to which your application got rejected.
Okay, thank you, sir. My second question is, actually yesterday there was a question raised, after 10 to 5, if somebody wants to access this AVU or any other course material, so how or he, how she or he can access this if they don't have laptop and desktop at their home? So my question is this, whether IIT Bombay is trying to develop any mobile app for this, so that nowadays mobile is a very common thing which anybody is handling at home or anywhere.
Okay.
So this could be a facility for them.
So just for your information, this software is developed by Amrita College. Actually, they are developing the mobile application for review. However, it is still under testing phase, due to which it was not we are not able to extensively use the mobile AVU interface.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. One of my participant is actually interested to ask you one more question.
Yeah, please.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir. My Srikant Peshatwa from SB Patil College of Engineering.
Huh.
My question is that what are the different limitations in presentation skill and how we can eliminate it?
What are the different limitations of presentations? See, the limitations is that the form and the function is the limitation. You can have specific features using each of these software. So, Microsoft PowerPoint has one functionality. The LibreOffice presentation has a different functionality. Google Slides has a different functionality. So, basically the limitations are, provided by the application developers. So there aren't, technically, so the limitations per se is only, let's say we can use only the amount of things that can go in a presentation, the kind of files that can be attached to a presentation, etc., etc. I think those are the limitations. Other than that, I think it's a more generic question. It depends on the software, specific software that you have for presentation.
How to evaluate the created website in this FDP program?
So the evaluation criteria will be provided by us in the next week, where we will tell you about the user goals and what has to be evaluated. So wait for week 4 and week 5, wherein we will provide you the exact criteria for peer reviews. Let me now move to the next RC, 1211. Yeah.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, my query is regarding the level of the course being offered. The teachers from computer science background and the similar streams find it very easy to do the task, do the assignment and understand the course. Whereas those from the arts background and the similar background find it a bit difficult. So my query is this, whether any beginner level courses available for those teachers to fill up the gap? Because we have a feeling that this is of an intermediate level.
Okay. The query is, are there beginner level courses? So the foundation course is the beginner level course, because last year when the same program was offered, we had people coming from arts background. So we had a teacher from Sanskrit who emerged as top performer. So just like how what we say about a student's capacity, saying outright that teachers from arts and science background will not be able to adjust quickly, I would say that we have instances where this has been contradicted. However, what we will definitely have done across in this FDP is provided you sufficient time for practice, and all the graded assignments are coming slowly. In any online course which is generic and given at such a large scale, what is more important is you make use of the discussion forum and interaction with your peers to understand the course more better. Now, beginner level courses are typically catered, very personalized, let's say a small amount of teachers. It cannot be done at such a large scale. When you look at the scale, we believe that the content is sufficient for a beginner level and the assignments are not too hard if you actually look at it, because it is only the sensitization. So in this particular FDP, the learning objective is towards sensitization to different ICT resources, not mastery on it. The mastery will come with continuous practice, and there are no other shortcuts for getting mastery in a course. And there are also instances where even computer science teachers found it very difficult. Basically, your affinity towards technology is what actually counts on how well you can use a ICT device.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Let me now go to St. Gids College of Engineering.
Sir, my question is, IIT Bombay is organizing some such ICT courses and of transforming the knowledge to the students, and the students are the stakeholders who are going to get benefited. Okay, so see, each university is following different course and timings, and the students and faculties are not able to fully attending these such courses. Is there any way so that you can organize a knowledge base? So based upon the course requirement, students or staffs of each particular college can avail the course based upon their requirements at any point of time, maybe in between semesters.
So this is something that was raised. So it's regarding the scheduling of the course like FTP. Let me just reiterate what Professor Fatak said yesterday. Scheduling it at such large scale according to convenience of each and every regions would be very difficult, because each of the regions follow a different timetable. However, what we can actually do is the estimated efforts. So the estimated effort in a week's activity in the current course is around 6 to 8 hours, that is spending at least 1 hour a day on understanding the different videos and interacting with your peers. So if you are able to actually do it, if you are able to actually put in that effort for a greater good, for even your own professional development, then that would be a best solution for this. One vision that we have in the future courses of this FDP is offering it across multiple time scales. Currently, we are devising out methodologies through which we can do a offering of the same course maybe in January or a new course in February, let's say a monthly release of the course, such that every teacher can register in the course that is convenient for them. But as of now, since it is done from IIT Bombay end, we do not have that facility to adapt it to the needs of the the general time schedules of the faculty at this moment. Or we will soon try to do it in such a format. 1028. Yeah, 1028.
So can you please clear once again to upload video for WordPress site? We are not getting it.
Okay. You can actually go and visit any of the video sharing sites, let's say YouTube or Vimeo or other things. See whether there is a Creative Commons video available for the particular topic. Now, what we have additionally provided is, in case you are not, if you are unable to find a video, we have given an alternate wherein it could be a simple faculty profile page with three different tabs, about me, research, and a blog post. So, in case you are not able to find the appropriate video, you can use the alternate format.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Let me now go to IPS Academy, Indore.
Very good afternoon, sir. Thanks for your clarifications. We are listening to you very carefully. Okay. Sir, as I am from non-technical genre, I would like to make my concept clear related with the website creation.
Okay.
My queries are, why we selected WordPress.com only as a tool to create website? And second thing is, how secure and safe it is? And are the professional developers, they are using it for their profession?
Okay, the question is regarding why WordPress was used. The simple reason is that it was a free and open source. Majority of the modules in WordPress is free and open source. There is also Drupal, but we thought the learning curve in Drupal is very high. That's why, because WordPress is a much more simpler instantiation of website creation. That's why we chose WordPress. Yes, security issues are there with any software. There are some security issues. Currently, it is beyond the purview of this particular FDP. Or what we will try to see is, can we, as learning extension resources, we will try to provide some papers or videos regarding security risks associated with WordPress.
Okay, sir. But can we further utilize it if suppose to we want to develop our professional website?
Yes, you can utilize it. See, the security aspect of any website is actually dependent upon multiple things. The application in which it is developed. So WordPress has its own, different programs that create the WordPress. And there are also, it also depends on where this WordPress is located. So you could have a site located in India, in a machine in India, or you could have your WordPress site located in China. Now, it really depends on the security, measures taken by this website to ensure that there aren't too much of hacks or manipulations. Now go to RVS College. RVS College 1111.
Good evening, sir. Sir, I need to clarify, do you have an Akash tablet clicker module like that for this session, sir?
So, AVU provides a functionality called polls. We are not extensively using it in the current FDP. However, we will try to use the clicker module in the next FDP when we talk about the pedagogy, because the clickers are one pedagogic tool also, wherein you will have polls and you will discuss with each other. So, we will be discussing this in FDP 201.
Okay, sir. Thank you for it. Yeah. One more question, sir. How far the course content we are preparing will be not repetition? Because we are usually preparing for our syllabus. There we need to refer only the textbooks and the reference books. And for a reference, we will refer some other books. And how we will prepare the course content, sir?
See, preparing a course, it is absolutely left to the teacher what they want to refer. You will have to carefully look at the objectives that you want your students to attain. Let's say you want more create level or more application from your students, then you will have to design activities. You have to go beyond the traditional textbooks, or you have to modify the content from the textbooks and do good activities in the classroom or outside the classroom. So what this FDP will teach you is how you can move out from the constraints of the syllabus or time schedule and still provide your learners with a much more meaningful learning experience.
Thank you, sir. And one more question.
Yeah.
How we will be having the students attentive throughout our session for 50 minutes if it is so? Because all the 50 minutes we can't show the video lecturing, all the 50 minutes we can't do the same thing. So we will be splitting our sessions into different kind of activities. That's a blended learning. So how far we will be having that attention for, towards the class for the students who is present inside the class physically?
Okay, so the question is regarding attention span of students. Research says that a student is typically not able to attend or consciously be attentive to around 7 to 10 minutes, or maximum cases around 17 minutes. But 7 to 10 minutes is what psychology findings have found out. The only way in which you can make sure that students are attentive is introduce more learner-centered activities. So, for example, asking a question in between and making them write something in their notebook. That is one way of ensuring that students are attentive to the question and they are engaging with the content. So, like what you saw in reflection spots, all the questions, we wanted you to do it in your course journal. So, these are pedagogic strategies. We'll be detailing more such active learning strategies in the next FDP.
Okay, sure, sir. And one more thing, sir. For WordPress, we are just, while having that session, we have a difficulty because you have just, not in the WordPress, mentor mentee, the interaction and how it was recorded, all those things. The video was not clear because we couldn't able to see how it was selected and what was done. Instead, if that was captured in a better way, we would be able to understand it, because this is a new thing. So it will be presented well, sir.
Okay, so we really get what you are implying at. So there are video and documentation guidelines on how to use AVIEW for virtual interactions. We'll be providing that as soon as the mentor-mentee groupings get finalized. We are expecting this to be released in the week 4.
Okay, sir. And one more thing, online assignment, do we have a session in our FTP, sir? How to create online assignment for the students and how to upload it and how to evaluate a thing?
So that is what you did in the learning management. You created a quiz in using Moodle, right? That is an online assessment. In the practice activity, if you actually see the demo course, you are asked to create a quiz for your students. It is the same online assessment. So there aren't, so different technologies provide different features. So we are talking about online assessment through Moodle. That's all. Go to the next remote center, 1176, University BDT College.
Good evening. There are two issues here in the center. Some of our colleagues, they have submitted the assignment, but unfortunately they have not checked. They have given only save button. Is there an option now to check their answers into that particular assignment? That is one issue.
The immediate answer is unfortunately no, because we have provided clear instruction before the quiz itself that you have to submit the final check button to submit the answer.
Okay. The second issue is that yesterday, because the lab session was earlier, it was informed that within 6 o'clock we have to complete. Most of us completed in a hurry.
Okay.
But now the time has been extended. Uh-huh. So most of us here, we have not given proper thought actually. So if that can be reversed back, is there a possibility?
Okay. So we will look at grading policy in more detail due to the technical issues that we have faced in the FDP. But more clarity on this will come during week 4, where we will announce the exact grading policy. We will try to take the top, let's say there are 5 quizzes, we will try to look at just the top 4 quizzes. So we will think of some mechanisms like these, and we will be informing you when the week 4 content is released.
Last one is that what about today's lab session, sir?
So today's lab assignment, as I told, there are some issues faced by different participants. So today's lab session, the questions will come tomorrow at 12 o'clock. We'll provide you sufficient time limit for answering those questions. We are just checking the availability, the stability of IIT Bombay X to ensure that there aren't further issues.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thanks a lot from our center too. Thank you.
1352, VNR Vignana Jyoti.
Sir, my question is regarding plagiarism in the course journal. Mm-hmm. So it's like most of us will be creating the course journal based on the videos.
Okay.
So although it's like when we did the course journal for week 1, me and my colleague ma'am had done it separately. But later on when we went for peer reviewing, we seen that not even us, most of the journals are like same content. And when you do the plagiarism, it's like 60 to 70% will be the same.
Okay. So it is like two people will have almost identical notebooks in a particular classroom, because the session is being handled by the same instructor and they are able to hear the same content in the classroom. So do not worry about similarity in the content of the course journal to a large extent. However, what you have to ensure is that suppose you found out that there is similarity between your content and somebody else's content, one small thing that you can try from your end is whether you can add little more information, rephrase some of the words if time permits. Course journal is more or less like sharing your experiences with others. So however, we will definitely check whether the structure and content are almost similar. That is something that we will definitely check, because it could be a copy paste from somebody else's course journal.
My another query is that, as you said, we can add our own ideas also in that, sir.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So let me move to the next RC.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, my name is Kalita. Sir, my question is, what is the minimum mark to get pass in this FDP program, sir? How can we improve?
Okay, so the minimum marks is, it is clearly said in the grading policy, it is 50%. Please refer the video on course grading policy and also the grading policy document.
Hello, good evening. Very nicely you are doing. Excellent, wonderful.
Yeah.
Then high speed Bluetooth connectivity, whether that would be useful, you know, locally connect.
It really depends on the infrastructure that you have. I'm not sure whether high speed Bluetooth connectivity, because it is limited by the area. If you have good infrastructure, it might be useful, but I would still advise you not to use it at a, in a regular course like this.
Okay. Then Dropbox, OneDrive can be blended with this?
Pardon?
Including Facebook, Dropbox, OneDrive,
okay,
Facebook.
So, yes,
could be
so
blended
we
with
have that? Provided. So we have provided option for the participant to use any files storing mechanism that they are comfortable with. We have not limited it to, okay, let's say Google Drive or OneDrive. You can use any file sharing mechanism that you have.
Okay. Here the AMU needs how much bandwidth?
2 Mbps.
100 Mbps or?
2 Mbps.
2 Mbps?
Yes. It has to be stable. Okay. It has to be consistently 2
Mbps. I found out that maybe 8 Mbps, so that can be used, I think, locally. I did not make that kind of attempt.
Okay. So we'll definitely provide you documents regarding AMU, which will clearly say how much is the bandwidth required and what all kind of infrastructure is required for a good AMU session.
Okay, excellent.
Let me now go to 1245 STC College of Engineering.
First of all, I want to thank you for the beautiful session you have conducted for us.
Okay.
Especially Professor Samit Sahasrabuddhi sir's session was very helpful.
Okay.
To make presentations and the bullet attack and all the spawns things they have told us. And Professor Pathak sir's comments on most of the things are very useful. And after thanking all, I have three questions to ask. First is, do we have to set up video for assignment? There is a checklist. On the checklist, there is a point that we have to send a video with the blog image. Is it so?
Okay, so regarding your, so can you tell me the first question? Can you repeat the first question again?
Sir, in the checklist, assignment checklist, there was a point that we have to send a video along with the blog.
Okay.
Do we have to make a video?
No, so for the current, so we have given an alternate provision wherein you can create a simple website without videos. If you actually look at the practice activity, it has been described clearly.
Okay. Second question was, make a website using Drupal.
So, Drupal. As I told earlier, currently we are not extensively using Drupal, just because the learning curve required in a course like this, where we actually be sensitized with different ICT tools rather than mastery of it. So, we just tell you about the different options that are available. We will definitely think of Drupal, learning Drupal more. When the next set of FDPs are released in January.
Okay, sir. And the final question about the course journal. Do we have to have a course journal and send it again? That means we have to link it.
So basically, the course journal is a continuous process. So it is like your notebook in a classroom. So you have to, every week you will have to update your course journal and finally upload it in your website.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Let me now go to the next institute, 1146.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
So we have a couple of people having a couple of questions.
Uh-huh.
My first question is, we have uploaded about two course journals of ours.
Uh-huh.
And do we need to follow any format? We don't have any format for our presentations for
so
uploading that.
There are no
so
formats.
We need to follow any formats.
There are no formats.
Okay.
It is up to you.
Okay, sir. My second question is, so I am interested to learn more things in this IIT Bombay X.
Mm.
So I have completed week 1 and week 2.
Mm.
So in case if I want to learn anything from the week 1, can I go back and search for the answers, because it is not,
yes,
visible?
Yes. So it is anytime, anywhere learning. So when the graded activities are released, then you will have a setting where the answers are getting correctly displayed.
Thank you, sir. And one more question from my friends.
Sir, my question is regarding documentation of Creative Commons license.
Okay.
You were speaking about that session earlier, and you told that you will be sharing the document soon.
Yes.
So I have one doubt in that.
Yeah,
like,
it will be coming in week 4. So because since it requires some amount of either on, so it will come by week 5, wherein we will, what do you say, extend it a little more and tell you about the exact Creative Commons in detail. So that you can, you will understand how to ethically upload and do various, put the resources in Creative Commons.
Okay, sir. And one more question is, you told that in case we are going to put any content in the web profile, we will be needing to put it under Creative Commons. Right?
Yes.
So in such a case, how to do that? Is there any procedure to follow that? I'm not aware of that.
Okay. So the question is how to insert Creative Commons in a website. Basically, you have to go to creativecommons.org. Which will provide you specific options to select the appropriate Creative Commons license. And if you actually look at creativecommons.org/choose, it will give you how to actually do it, let's say in a website or even in a document.
Okay, sir. Yeah. And one more question. You told that this week we will not be needing to complete the WordPress website creation, right?
Basically, the practice activity has to be completed. No graded activities are there.
Okay. Actually, like we have a checklist box and we have content in that we should be completing the WordPress. In case we are still in the process of creation,
no issues.
We get so a wrong mark.
No, so do not worry because the checklist is only for your own reference. You can take your own time because it depends on your schedule. However, there is a graded activity for which you need to follow the correct tight schedules that have been provided. 1065 Finolex Academy of Management.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I would like to thank team IIT Bombay for putting up such an interactive session yesterday and today. Actually, like to thank Sundar sir and Samir sir for a very interesting session, and I'm sure all the participants here enjoyed their session.
Yeah, thank you.
Sir, there is a point I want to make here that some participants are facing problem in submitting their assignments due to the technical problems, I guess.
Yes, so for them the due dates will be extended. So for people who have not yet submitted week 2 activities, we are going to extend the due dates as based on how IIT Bombay X is stable.
And sir, one more thing, I would like to really appreciate the effort that you have put up this time. All the remote centers, at least those who have got associate faculty, they are really helpful. Our Goelkar ma'am is one of them, and she is really helping out all the participants, and that is wonderful because I remember doing this FDP last year without an associate faculty. It was really difficult.
Yes.
And it was a really wonderful idea that you have put up to have a mentors on each center. Thank you very much for this. And I like ma'am want to ask a question, so please let's over to her now.
Yeah,
I'm working here as an associate professor.
Hi ma'am.
I want to know, sir, when we will got the mentees.
So we will be releasing the list by week 4 because the grouping is a manual process. It's not an automated process. We are hopeful that the grouping will be done by the start of week 4.
Okay, another one question, sir. In the assignment, week 1 and week 2 assignments, the course journal and the videos,
yes,
those videos are uploaded in the IIT Bombay X discussion. We,
yes,
are to see the gradings of that.
So please note that the graded activities of course journal, it is done in the discussion forum itself. So it is not exactly a graded activity. It is rather an exercise to familiarize you with peer review, wherein we have provided specific conditions and you will have to rate your peer based on these conditions. And since it's a subjective grading, we have not made it as a graded activity.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, so
thank you.
Let me now go to RC1116.
My question is this one. In mentor-mentee model, are you provide the spot for on the AV? Yeah, we have some choice for the slot.
Can you repeat the question?
in mentor mentee model, will you provide the slot on the AVU? Yeah, we have some choice for the splitting.
So currently the question is whether we will be providing slots for mentor mentee interaction. The answer is yes, because this is the first time we are trying it out. We cannot extend it to the let's say for individual choices. What we'll do is we'll give a longer window of time and which could be agreed upon by the mentor and mentees to interact with each other. 1259 NDMVP.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hello.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
Sir, my question is very actually basic. I found one limitation for these uses of ICT at a student end, because most of our students are from rural area, so it is difficult to get the connectivity for these students after college hours.
So this has been discussed yesterday, wherein the access is not provided. So the effort, it's a national effort that we are trying to provide last mile access even in internet connectivity. So till the last mile access is provided, what you can do is, let's say on a Saturday or a Sunday, you can provide facility for the students to use the internet or the other technology resources at your own institute. There have been instances of several remote centers doing this for not just for students, but for several other individuals like school teachers, other students, etc. in various courses. So you could actually look into these models and provide facilities for the students.
Okay, sir, thank you. One more query, sir. As a teacher, we are highly time bound to our activities related to curriculum. So could you guide us about how to time management while using these ICT resources?
There aren't any, what do you say, standard ways in which time management can be done. It really depends on individual user. How are they organizing their work? How are they scheduling access to technology? And see, it actually, rather than focusing on the syllabus, what you should focus is on the learning outcomes of the student, because that is more important than syllabus completion. If every teacher has this attitude, then you can do a lot of things with technology. So basically, define good learning objectives and work on solving it out or achieving those objectives.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, so let me now go to the next remote center, NMIMS, Shirpur.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, myself, Dr. Sanjay Sharma. I am from NMIMS, Shirpur.
Okay.
And sir, I would like to ask one question regarding to peer review assessment. Mm-hmm. Will you provide the peer review assessment demo for all the participants?
So it has been already been provided. The peer review assessment, the demo videos have been provided in week 3. If you carefully look at peer review and how it is done in IIT Bombay X, you can see 2 videos already uploaded in week 3.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So let me now go to the final 2 institutes.
All our participants are moved to the lab for the lab session. Mm-hmm. So our question is, when you are going to float that lab session, lab 2 session?
Okay. So the lab 2 session is what I informed earlier at 3:30. The lab 2 session has been moved to tomorrow afternoon, because there are some stability issues with IIT Bombay X. We are trying to resolve it, and as soon as IIT Bombay X becomes stable once again, we'll be releasing the lab 2 assignment.
Okay. The another question is that the link for the web WebPress, when we go into paste it over that discussion forum.
So you can paste your WordPress link now also. However, there is a specific assignment where you will do peer review of the WordPress sites week 5. So that is when there is going to be actual peer review of the the WordPress sites.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So let me now move to the final remote center, NDMVP, KBT College, Nashik.
I don't want to ask you any question, but I want to congratulate you and your team for taking a great effort for training the trainer. But I want to request you, sir, instead of covering only 20 states from India, only try to cover all 29 states and 7 Indian territories.
Can you speak slowly? I'm unable to hear you.
Sir, instead of covering only 20 states from India, try to cover all 29 states
Yeah, so this is regarding coverage of institutes. See, it's really not in our hand. We have sent out requests for all remote centers across all the states in India. Our very few remote centers are interested in programs like these. That is why we have limitations of only 20 states. We are open
sir,
to all.
One more question is there.
Yeah.
When we have created our website, and in that we have created our blog, mm-hmm. and under that blog, student can comment.
Yes.
My question is that whether student can comment only by writing, or whether they can upload the graph for analysis, or any picture, or any video on which they may have doubt.
So they can they? It really depends on the version of WordPress that you are using. Some HTML editors allow embedding images, videos, etc. as response comments.
Yeah, yes.
So it really depends on the version of WordPress that you are using.
Upload images or videos?
Yeah, so yes.
And so that if having any doubt on...
The answer is yes. It really depends on the version of WordPress that you are using. If you are using an HTML comment, then students will be able to upload HTML, what do you say, images, videos, or other things onto the comment.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Yeah.
We are from the field of pharmacy, and because of this FDP, we could create our own website and we can use it for our students. So, thank you very much.
Yeah, the same. Thank you for telling us that it has been useful for you. So, there is one final remote center, 1093.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. First of all, I am very much thankful to you. From last 3 to 4 hours, you are continuously clearing our doubts. Sir, I want to ask you that. Sir, is there any kind of Indian community of WordPress or Drupal is there where we can get some kind of widgets or some kind of data for our students?
It really have to. So there is an active community for WordPress and Drupal across the country. You really have to visit the website and understand the contributions, how different regions have contributed to the software. Short answer is yes, but you will have to explore it in the main website.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So with this, we come to the end of interaction session for today. Let me again announce that the graded activities will be extended for another day till IIT Bombay X becomes stable. The lab assignment will be released at 12 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, and we'll be providing almost a day for completing it. So with this, it is thank you from IIT Bombay side. I thank all the workshop team, the studio team who have been patiently handling this session at our end. I also thank Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddhi and Dr. Fatak, who had visited remote centers and participated in this session from there. I also thank all the associate faculties who are providing continuous support and amazing work, doing amazing work regarding mentorship within this FDP. So it is thank you from our side. Goodbye. Namaste.